Mercy, what can I do for you?
I need to know how to turn a man on.
Well, I'm not a plastic surgeon, but I'll do what I can. See, Mercy, you touched Steve's car. Now, what did Steve ask you not to do?
Touch his car.
What did you do?
Touched his car.
I can't hear you.
I touched his car, so what?
What? So you disobeyed a man, which means you weren't doing your job as a woman. See, the thing is, women don't understand that men don't really need them. See, if you want to talk to someone, you talk to the guys. If you want to have some fun, you go with the guys. You want sex, you reminisce with the guys. Now let's get back to women. What are they for? Two C's. Cooking? Kitchen.
Oh. Al, I'm amazed your knuckles don't bleed when you walk.
Good day, Marcy.
I'm sorry. Go on.
Very well. So we've established that we don't need you. Now, let's ask ourselves, what the heck do we keep you around for? It's because we're optimists. We believe that you can change. The world-renowned social scientist, Mr. Hugh Hefner, has made great strides in that area.
Get to it, Java man.
Very well. Mercy, your problem is you're not servile enough. So, young lady, if you want to save your marriage, you're going to have to learn to compromise a little bit. Put down that briefcase. Pick up the dish rag and be a woman.
Al, I can only say this. There may be something alive with fewer brain cells than you. But whatever it is, wherever it is, I'm sure its name is Bundy. You should be on all fours, pulling a wagon full of borax across the desert. Your compost, your phlegm, you are a true pork product.
You gonna take my advice?
Yes. Thank you, Al, for your time and help. Pig.